Hello everyone, my name is Sam Spade and I've created a short tutorial here for talking about GUI coordinates and creating some simple GUI buttons. Making GUI buttons is actually incredibly easy if you know how to. The problem is, if you don't know the trick to doing it, it can actually be a little bit frustrating. So in this tutorial, I'm just going to walk through the basics of how you do it, and you'll see that you can create a GUI button with just 2 to 3 lines of code depending upon how you want to do it. The biggest hurdle to get over, the biggest thing to understand, when creating a GUI button is the difference between room coordinates and GUI coordinates. So let's say that this gray box is the room. It will have the coordinates 0, 0 up here to its width and height, which I've just said are 2000 and 1000 down here. Note that this isn't necessarily to scale, probably pretty close, but I did just pick these numbers at random. So if I were to put my mouse up here, the mouse's position would be 0, 0. And if I put it down here, it would be 2000 for the X position and 1000 for the Y position. This would be the value that you would get if you used mouse X and mouse Y. If I put my mouse in the very center of the room, you would get 1000 for mouse X and 500 for mouse Y. Now let's say you have your GUI layer. The GUI layer is basically your game window. That's a slight oversimplification, but unless you're doing something crazy, that's what it's gonna be. 0, 0 is going to be the top left of your game window, and the bottom right of your game window will be your GUI width and GUI height. Here, I've just made it half of room width and room height. So GUI width is 1000, GUI height is 500. So if I put my mouse here in the top left corner of my game window, you'll just have to pretend that the game window can only see this much right here, then this would be 0, 0 for my mouse's GUI position, but it would be 500 for my mouse's X position and 250 for my mouse's Y position in room space. Down here, my mouse position in GUI space would be 1000 for the X and 500 for the Y. And if I put my mouse here, dead center in the view, then the GUI coordinates of my mouse would be 500 for the X and 250 for the Y, but the room position would be 1000 for the X and 500 for the Y. And this is why you can have problems when you try to create a GUI button. Because if you use the room position, you are not gonna be in the right place. Your mouse is gonna, the game is gonna think your mouse is somewhere it isn't, right? Because 1,500 is not the same position in space as 500, 250. And just to take this example one farther, let's say we move the view over here. Well, now the view is over here, but this is still 0, 0 in the GUI. So 0, 0, 0, 0. But note that now my mouse would be at an entirely different place. If it were over here, my mouse's X position would be 0 in room space and 450 in GUI space. If it were over here in the center, it would be 500, 700 in room space, but 500 and 250 still in GUI space. So this is the thing to keep in mind when you want to interact with something on the GUI layer. You are using the GUI coordinate system, not the room coordinate system. And that means two things. Number one, you cannot use mouse X and mouse Y because those refer to room positions. Number two, you cannot use any of the built-in GameMaker mouse events or gesture events that rely on clicking on the object. You can use the global ones, as we'll talk about in a moment, but any of the built-in ones that just rely on clicking on the object also use the mouse's X and Y position or the touch's X and Y position in room space, which again will not allow you to click on an instance in GUI space, unless those two values happen to coincide because they're using different coordinate systems. So how do you create a GUI button then? Well, it's actually, like I said in the beginning, very easy, and you can do it with just a few lines of code. First, you need to deactivate the draw event. Then you need to draw the object in the GUI event. Then you use the step event. There's actually one other way you can do it, but we'll use the step event first as an example. And instead of using the mouse's X and Y position, you use the mouse's GUI X and Y position. So I'm going to switch over to GameMaker Studio 2. I've created a simple room right here. I don't have the button yet. We're going to create that. But I can scroll around the room with left, right, up, and down. It just created a simple background so you can see that the view is indeed moving. And now also in this corner up here, you can see my mouse's GUI X position and GUI Y position. And again, up here, close to 0, 0. Down here, it's my GUI width, GUI height. And you can see that as I move the room around, the GUI X and GUI Y position of my mouse doesn't change because the mouse isn't moving, but its position in the room does change. So I'm going to pull up the code here, and you can see that for mouse X and mouse Y, I'm just using the built-in GameMaker variables, mouse X and mouse Y. But to get the GUI position, you have to use this function, device mouse X to GUI, and then the device you want to use. If you're not using multiple touches, the mouse on like Windows or Mac is always going to be 0. So device mouse X to GUI 0, device mouse Y to GUI 0. And this will get you the GUI position. So now let's create the object. Object button. Got a sprite for it already. It's just a blue box. So the first thing we want to do is create a draw event, because GameMaker Studio 2 automatically draws the object using the room position with the draw event. This simply overwrites that. If you don't know, this will simply overwrite that, and now no object will be drawn. But we do want to draw the object. We just want to draw it on the GUI layer. So we're going to go over here, draw GUI, and we're just going to write draw self. So we are just canceling the regular draw event and using that same idea or that same type of draw event in the GUI layer. Now we're going to go to the step event, and we're going to say if mouse check button pressed MB left. So that's if we click a button. Then we're going to say if position meeting, and here we have to use device mouse X to GUI 0, device mouse Y to GUI 0. Make sure I got the correct number of parentheses. Yep. Oh, nope. What did I do wrong here? Oh, I have to have the third argument, which is this one. So we're just going to check for position meeting with this instance. And now we're simply going to say show message hello world. Okay, so let's put this object in our room. And one thing you can note is that even though it's going to be on the GUI layer, since this view is the same resolution of our GUI layer, we can actually use it to place it in our view. So we want it to be dead center of our GUI. So there we go. All right, so again, this is our view. Our view and our GUI layer have the same resolution. I'll talk at the end about what to do if that's different. But for our purposes here, they've got the same resolution. So we can actually use this as a guide for where it will show up. And now we're simply going to stop our current program, rebuild it. Okay, if everything is working correctly, we should be able to click on this button, get hello world, click in a couple different places. Yep, so that's working. And now we can move it around so you can see that there's a difference, but it's still working. So there we go. We've created the button with just a few lines of code. We got 1, 2 lines of code here. I wouldn't really count this, so we've got 2 lines of code. And then we've got our third line of code. 3 lines of code, we've got our GUI button. But now there's a couple tricks that I think are worth seeing. So number one, if we come up here, we can create a macro, GUI mouse X, where this macro is just device mouse X to GUI and GUI mouse Y, where we've got device mouse Y to GUI. And now we can actually write this very close to the way we would normally. We can just say GUI mouse X, GUI mouse Y. And if we were to rerun it, it would work the same way. So let's do that. So again, come over here. It works. All right, so everything still works. So the next thing that I want to show you is what happens if your GUI resolution is different from your view resolution. Well, one trick you can do is you can simply take a viewport that you're not using. So let's actually make view 0 not visible. You could take a viewport that you're not using, and let's just say that our width and height of the viewport was double. So it's going to be 2,000, 1,000. Again, let's just say 2,000, 1,000. All right, so now we can see that this is, if this were our GUI's resolution, we could see that this view right here represents our GUI. And we could take this object and we could move it around. So now we could actually build up our GUI or HUD or whatever we wanted to using this as a reference, and it would look correct when we ran our program. And again, when you're done, you can just say, okay, let's say we want this button here. You can just say viewport one, we don't actually want that one. We really just want viewport zero, so there we go. But it would still work. It would show up where you expected it to in the GUI layer. The last thing I want to talk about is an alternative to using the step event. So like I said, all of these events right here use the mouse's X and Y position in the room. But one other thing you could do is you could use the global mouse events. And this is true for gestures as well. And this is a lot more useful for gestures. So these gestures all use the mouse's X and Y, or the gestures X and Y in room space. But there are some very helpful gestures that you might want to use in GUI space. So you could use the global events for these gestures and then just check the touches GUI positions. So let's do this with the mouse. Let's do a global. Let's do a global mouse released event. So global left released. And then get this out, come over here. We will copy this code, global left released. But now we don't need to do this check because this check is already happening as part of the event for the release. And we'll just say left release. All right. And let's run it one more time. I think we're going to have an error here because I forgot to make my object visible. Let's stop it. Let's move it over here. Let's do it up in the corner this time. And now let's run it. Okay. So I had an error because I didn't comment this code out, and the show message basically interrupts the click. It wasn't working. So now I've commented out our normal click. We'll just be using this when we run the code. All right, so as you can see, our button is over here. And when we release, left release. All right, so there you go. Creating a GUI button on the GUI layer that is interactable on the GUI layer, the basics of how to do it, and some tips and tricks to make it easier, some different ways to do it so that you can work with gesture events and so on as well. One more thing that I want to mention before I finish here is that I will have a link to the source code below that you'll be able to get if you want it. It's simple enough, you probably don't need it, but it'll be there. That's it. Thanks for watching.